Hello, I'm Toby Jetson, and you join me in my home studio in the cider capital of the world, Somerset. Great to be here. Fantastic to be asked to take part in this. And this is my Planet Rock lockdown session. Thank you very much. Okay, want to give a couple of shout outs. People have sent me some little messages on through my socials. So hi to Dean Gibbons, hi to Simon Gledhill, hi to Amanda Huff, and hi to Catherine Toomer. Hope you're all good. And I'm going to keep on with Little Angels for the moment, if that's okay. And this is, well, hopefully you'll know this.
Little Angels. cared about nobody, cause no one cared about John. He crawled his way this far through life, it's the original way of a song. Took himself to the wild blue yonder to see what he could find. Now he's the king of the dusty jungle, he's got peace of mind. We'll be right back.
Okay, so I've got a question or two being sent via the wonderment of the Tinterweb. So here we go. I've got a question here from David Penberthy. Seen you many times over the years, but my fave gigs have been when you played bootleggers in Kendall. Acoustic and with gun. What memories do you have of playing that brilliant venue? Always fantastic. I think when I was coming back on the scene and trying to sort of get going again, the promoter at the time, who sadly is no longer with us, John T. Martindale, was an amazing supporter of mine. So yeah, sending out lots of love to Booties. A brilliant, brilliant place. Another quick question. Steve Harris, if Brian May rang you up and asked if you would record a Queen cover with him, which track would you choose? Well, I've just done one. I did 39 from Night at the Opera as a little busk, which I love doing. Flipping heck, if Brian May rang me up and asked me, I'd do anything. I'd sing the alphabet, frankly. But there we go. Okay, want a couple more shouts out here. Jackie Hall, Penny Marshall, Doug Byrne, my mate in Bristol. Thanks for joining us. Yeah, I'll carry on, if that's okay. Fantastic to be here. Gonna try something from Wayward Sons now. See if you remember, if you know this. Welcome to our new century. Everything's the same. Buy yourself a happy life with your plastic friend. Make some time and loose as you spend. And the rules they worship don't mean much when it all comes down. In the blink of an eye, who was once enemy was the ground. And the screams of we'll take care of that. Let the lies take the place of the facts. Leave them all at the bottom. A mother nature, a witch. Play your heat to the temp of the age. Some sound great acoustic, some don't. Make up your own mind. Anyway, another quick question perhaps. I've got one here from Roger Williams, who says, do you wish Little Angel's second album had been able to be called Spitfire as originally planned, or was the enforced change a blessing? Hard to say, really. As most people know who were into the band, we had to change the name due to actually the Gulf War, and we were getting banned from all sorts of places, which was kind of ironic because the song is actually very it's an anti-war song. That was kind of the whole point of it. But anyway, there we go. I don't know if it would have made a difference. I think Spitfire was probably a better title, but then, hey, Young Gods has become a bit of a classic for the fans, hasn't it? So, you know, it is what it is. But thanks for that. A couple more shout-outs. Justin Bordley, Craig Keegan Marsden, and Paul Leahy? Anyway, thanks for being here. See if you know, there's another one from Wayward Sons. Fantastic, thank you. Maybe just one other quick question, because I know we're running out of time. I've got one here from Stuart Patton. What track and with who are you proudest of recording it with? And can you play it now, please? Okay, I'm very proud. I guess this actually speaks quite well. I'm very proud of the stuff we've done with Wayward Sons. I'm very proud of everything I've done, really, in lots of ways. It's hard making good records. And it's a challenge every time. And I don't know whether I've ever made a fantastic record or not. I don't know. It's all about the fans for me. And a lot of the fans have been asking for me to play this one. This is the first time I ever played this, so who knows what's going to happen. But this is from the Truth album. This one's called Fade Away.
faith has fallen. Turn all tired eyes to gaze on their lover's lonely face. Hear the phantom voices calling. In the distance, hear the drums.
Actually, gotta start that again, sorry. This is Fade Away. Thank you. I like this.
gone missing. It's too big to care. Left all the lights and the good times you share. And it's been such a long time. Down in the halls, he stayed just the same. Though he's the king, he's the pawn in this game. Don't pray for me. Don't let me go.
Getting close to the end now. Just a couple more shout outs. David Howland. I want to say actually shout out to Julie Warden and Andrew Moore, who both requested in great big capitals, please play Fade Away. So I hope that first rendition, because I was terrified playing that, I've got to be honest. I hope that was okay for you. And my mate Paul Todd. So I'm going to finish off now. And I just want to dedicate this to Planet Rock, this track actually, because without Planet Rock, Wayward Sons would not have got the launch pad we needed and all the rest of it. So big thanks to John, to Rick, to Paul Anthony and to Wyatt and everyone else. I mean, it's just been amazing support. So yeah, I hope you've enjoyed this. I've been Toby Jepson and this has been my Planet Rock lockdown session. Hello. Thanks for being here, folks. This has been my Planet Rock lockdown session. Take care.